สวัสดีค่ะ Hello Welcome to today's episode of Stay Healthy Doctor Talk. Today we're going to focus on office syndrome. What it is and how does it affect the spine. And today we know that office syndrome is something that a lot of people suffer a lot, especially those who work and are in this age around 30 to 50 years old. And it's become more prevalent, especially now that we are working from home in the COVID time. Bhagavan really stressed the importance of this and has found that it does require a multidisciplinary approach. Here at our Spine Institute, we have now an office syndrome clinic right inside our institute. And I have here today two of our specialists who will provide you with information on this. First, I'd like to introduce Dr. Virapan Khonsongthai. Yes, he is our director of the Spine Institute. And another one is our Dr. T. Sivivetara. And he is our physical medicine and rehabilitation specialist, also in our sports and, center and lifestyle center. Yes. So I'd like to start us off with Dr. T. So what is office syndrome and what are the causes?
Yes. Actually, office syndrome is not only the disease. It's a group of disease or symptoms that related to office work type. So right now, not only work in the office. If you work from home, but use the computer, use mobile phone, use the tablet, even in the student, they can affect and develop the office syndrome. This comes from prolonged working or use the workstation in wrong posture or improper posture. And initially we will find the office syndrome mostly in the working age, but right now, like I talk right now, even the student or the old age people, they usually use the tablet or mobile phone. So everyone will can be developed the office syndrome. Office syndrome can affect to multiple organs in whole body, from head to toes.
Yes, and what are the symptoms that we find?
Yeah, this is some common symptoms or disease that classify as office syndrome. Initially, I will start from the head.
Yes.
Headache, neck pain, shoulder pain, back pain, include upper and lower back, and also some kind of wrist pain such as the tenosynovitis of some part of your thumb, and also carpal tunnel syndrome. The compression of the nerve at the wrist joint. So the other thing that you will not think this is office syndrome is your GI symptoms, such as bloating, constipation, and also sometimes when you use your eyes a lot to work with computer or tablet, your eye will be dry. So dry eye is another one of office syndrome, and also dry skin.
Wow. So as a syndrome, it does constitute many, many symptoms.
Yes.
And people would just think that with an office work, you might just suffer only your neck pain or things, but actually you're letting us see that there's so many different symptoms that if in combination, we got to think about this as an office syndrome.
But today we will focus to the axial pain, such as neck, shoulder and back pain, because this is very common when we talk about office syndrome, we will think about this.
Yes. Okay. And since we're focusing on the axial, what are the preventions that we can have for this office syndrome?
This is the good question, but very difficult to do it. The first thing is we have to correct the posture and also correct the working station. It's very, very easy to correct the posture when you sit and work. Your core axial should be straight in vertical line. Some joint will be bend around 90 degrees, not too much bending or not too much stretch. Like a shoulder should be around 90 degrees. Your elbow should around
90 degrees.
Yes, yes. And your back should have the good back support. If you cannot support your back properly on the chair, you can use some pillow or cushion to put under your seat or under your back to help you to adjust. And the other thing that you should not forget is your feet. Your feet should put fully rest on the floor or use the foot rest. That will be better. So the muscle should be relax during working, not contract too much all the time. This is the whole thing to adjust your working posture for your working station. If you use the computer such as the laptop computer to work, I recommend you to buy separate keyboard and also mouse. Don't use keyboard and trackpad. Mouse pad in the laptop, because very difficult to adjust the level. If you put the laptop computer on the table, you have to bend your neck and look downward too much. If you support the laptop higher, your arm level is not proper to use the keyboard in the laptop. This is the example. So if you can adjust your working station, adjust your work posture or position properly, that will be prevent or solve initial problem for office syndrome.
Yeah, I can see that now, because sometimes patients, especially younger ones, they play their games all on the mobile phone or use their laptop.
Yes.
But actually, you're letting us know that for long-term use, it should be very much matching your body, and you must position everything so that it all stays relaxed. And that might need a PC, like a real computer that has the dimensions that you could really adjust to.
And there are some other factors that will affect to office syndrome. We should proceed to the other slide.
Yes.
Okay. The other factor that very important is working duration and also working time. Working duration is mean when you sit for one time, you should not sit too long. I think maximum should not more than 2 hours. You should stop your work for a while and get up and change your posture or do the other activity and come back to work. And working time is mean total time in the day that you work. Some people, even you limit your working duration not more than 2 hours, but you work whole days from 8 to 12 o'clock, that will be too much. Your body, your muscles, and also your psychological status will be very stressed. And the other thing is you can improve your muscles to prepare the muscle, make it stronger or healthier for prolonged working. The way to make the muscles healthy is exercise. And the other thing, don't forget, is the nutrition. You know, muscle need the nutrition such as calcium, magnesium. This is very important for muscle function. If you don't eat in various food, eat only the same things every day, you will lack of some nutritional nutrient. So this will be not good for your muscles.
So now working people from home, they always do Zoom. And I can hear some of the people in the working class, they go, oh, the Zoom meeting is back to back, back to back. Mm-hmm. I don't even have time to go to the bathroom. I think this is also another good reason that they should get up and walk around.
Correct.
Any particular thing to help relax the muscles or that you would...
The good way to relax the muscle is stretching. Very easy, you can stretch in your workstation. But today we will not go into the detail for stretching and exercise. I have some example for the structural or spine change. If you stay in wrong position or wrong posture for working, but this is normal spine. If you look in the front view or the back side of your spine, you will see the left picture. It should be straight, don't have a curve. But if you look on the side view, you will see the spine have a lot of curve. One curve in your neck, curve to the front, and one curve at your thoracic spine, a little back curve, and the other curve at your lumbar spine. This is normal spine. In some people who sit for a long time or stay in wrong posture, the muscle function or muscle contraction will make the curve of the spine change. Initially, it will be changed just temporarily. If you change your posture, it will be back to normal. But if you usually do it again and again every day, the muscle function, the muscle contraction, the force that take action to the spine can make some part of the spine change permanently, such as the pressure that comes through the spine and action on the intervertebral disc can make the disc collapse, can make the small joint in the spine have more shearing force, more weight bearing or pressure or stress, and permanently change. The other good example on the other one, this called Tex neck syndrome. You ever heard about this?
Yes, I think I have heard it. As I said, there's a lot of people on the train, they do a lot of
When we use a lot of mobile phone or tablet, we have to bend our neck forward. You can look at this picture in some angle of the bending of your neck. You may increase the pressure in your spine differently, right? This picture. So if you usually do it again and again, the pressure that take action to the spine or on the disc can push the disc backward or make the disc collapse and make permanent change to the spine.
This is, I think, is the key message that we might not be aware of, is that we just think it's going to cause pain.
Yeah.
And it's not permanent, but actually it does permanently change over time.
Most of office syndrome can be treated, can be cured by only massage, stretching, exercise, or physical therapy. But if your structure is permanent change, like I mentioned, you cannot do like that. So I will tell you some red flag signs or some symptoms that you should come to see the doctor. If you have severe pain, cannot relieve by take a rest or change posture. How can we say the severe pain? If we classify the level of pain like a number from 0 to 10, severe pain is more than 7. 7 up to 10 is classified as severe pain. Especially if pain characteristic is radiating pain from neck to shoulder to arm or hand, this should be concerned. And the next one is neurological symptoms. Like if you have the numbness in your arm your hand or in your leg, your feet. This is neurological symptoms that we have to suspect that something happened in your spine and compressed to the nerve. You have to come to see doctor properly. And the last one, this is very important, is the weakness, loss of muscle power. If you think your muscle is weaker, cannot lift your arm properly, cannot lift the weight like you can before, this is the weakness and the sign of the nerve compression. So you have to come to see the doctor and have to see Dr. Veerapan because he is a spine specialist.
So you will definitely make that referral if there's any symptoms that are alarming like this. Of course, people might come see you just for pain, or they will stay and just think, it's okay, but these things must come in to see our specialist, and you would definitely make
So you can use the red flag sign to screening the people who come to Spine Institute or Office Syndrome Clinic. If they have the red flag sign, like I mentioned, so we can transfer directly to the spine surgeon.
And this also includes like bowel and bladder symptoms.
Yes, right.
So that's why we are sitting here together today.
Yes.
Because over the years, as a spine specialist, I'm a neurosurgeon working on spine and the director of the Burma Spine Institute, we have seen changes. Because normally the patient that come to our center is a high intensive patient, like say with the red flag sign, neck pain radiate down to the arm, back pain radiate down to the leg with numbness, weakness or bowel bladder symptom, which I think nowadays most people know that this is critical. You need to see the spine specialist because it's a nerve symptom. But over the years we have seen a lot of so-called office syndrome. I think the key is I think I can clear that every single person nowadays they have mobile phone. Yeah, and mobile phone, you cannot press the mobile phone, look into the eye level and manage the mobile phone, and they use it more than a phone. They use it as a laptop or the desktop, and this is totally wrong. Yeah, so we have seen a lot of neck pain problems. That's why we were talking, and then we agreed to establish the office syndrome clinic and educate the population, the publication. And when the patient come to the hospital, that means they treat themselves without success, so they come, right?
Yes.
So we have criteria to screen the serious patient.
Yes.
Okay, for example, like a red flag that we mentioned, you need to see the spine specialist. Most of them are surgeon or interventionist.
Yes.
And we need investigation like x-ray, like MRI scan, and very detailed physical exam to exclude the serious problem. But if you have a neck pain or back pain without radiating pain and less than 3 months, it's not a chronic pain.
Yeah.
So that kind of case we treat as a muscle pain or a so-called office syndrome. And then when something more severe happen or it doesn't recover, so we have certain point that at this point we have to do the investigation. So we work together like a multidisciplinary team approach, and we have a conference once a week together.
Oh, I love the systemic approach that our hospital has, and that's run by both of you, because it's like early detection and also good handover of cases so that there won't be anything missed. And you continuously talk to each other as well through the care of the patient.
Right.
So it's not like a standalone place where one person is just working by themselves and not sure what's going on with the patient. And that would be harder to refer, but now this is already made that we have in our mind in the beginning that there's a possibility of a spine injury, and there might be something that needs neurosurgeons specialty to look into so that to rule out whether the patient really needs anything.
And we put all the doctors together in the one center rather than the patient try to find the doctor from center to center, even different floor. So that's the new philosophy for Bumrungrad, like a one-stop in the center service, but the doctor will refer to each other if needed.
Yeah, this is probably make all of us who are patients here feel assured and comforted that our doctors are really talking to each other. They really make plans about the care so that nothing is missed, because I'm sure a lot of patients, they wonder about these things, whether they're going to need surgery or not, and how are they going to approach the doctor for this. But right here at our spine center is already a team that really thinks about that. And also, it also works vice versa. I'm sure that if you have any surgery, then you can still refer back to our specialist force.
Rehabilitation play in every part of the disease or the problem. Even we do surgery, we still need rehabilitation.
Yeah. And in our next session, we're going to have a more in-depth focus of the these spine surgeries and the approach to the healing and treatment of the spine conditions by Dr. Virpal. So.
Any questions from the?
Yeah, I think I. Let me look. Oh yes. So thank you, Nathi Junt. If our work have to stand for a very long time, 3 to 4 hours, what should we do?
Spread it to short duration, maybe every 1 hour or 2 hours. Just walk around to take one coffee or go into the toilet and come back to work again. That will be the best thing. Don't stay for a long time and work until finish.
If they did stay stand like 3 to 4 hours a long time already, is there anything they need to do to maybe reverse any effect of that?
Should not only sit. So during sitting, we can do some movement. Just a little exercise, like move your leg, your foot, your ankle for muscle pumping, or just stretching your arm, stretching your neck, then that will be better.
So the key message is to work with the muscles,
yes,
to help them shift positions and maybe even to relax.
Uh-huh. Don't stay still.
Don't stay still.
Yeah, either sit or stand. Don't stay still. Yeah.
Okay. The next question from Bangladesh. What should be our diet plan in this pandemic situation when we can't go out?
Very good questions.
Yeah.
If you cannot go out in this situation because of COVID-19 pandemic, so I recommend you to have many food in your house and try or plant some vegetable in your house. This is very good idea because you have exercise and also relaxation, and you will get the food. You can use something like a seed to put on the soil and let it grow up to the vegetable. That is very easy.
But we have to be careful of the syndrome also from gardening. If we do it too long as well.
Right.
Yes. Next question. How is myofascial pain syndrome diagnosed?
Okay. So myofascial pain syndrome is one kind of muscle pain that have a specific characteristic. In myofascial pain syndrome, the people will have the most tender point in the muscles. This is called trigger point. Trigger point can be produced the pain in that area and also radiating to the other area. Sometimes it's similar and difficult to differentiate from the spine problem. And at the trigger point, if you palpate at that point or press at that point, you will find some thickening band of the muscle under your fingers. And the treatment is to make this thickening band relax. We call release the trigger point and also improve the muscle healthier, make it healthier, improve the muscle function, make it healthy, stronger to prevent more trigger point.
So we can find myofascial pain in office syndrome too.
Yes, it's very big part and very common in office syndrome.
And finally, it will affect your spine, like
yes.
Dr. Satish said, okay, over the years.
Yes.
So that kind of degeneration of the spine happens.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah, if I have back pain for a very long time, on and off, both neck, shoulder, and back, do I need to worry, or how do we know when should we go to see the doctor? I think we've kind of explained a lot
yes.
of that with the red flags.
Yeah, and I think I would like to emphasize a little bit, if you don't have the arm or leg pain, but you have only neck or back pain, we call axial neck pain or axial back pain.
Yes.
So if you go for easy treatment for yourself, it doesn't recover
yeah.
within 3 months or keep coming back, that is the criteria of the chronic back pain or chronic neck pain. You should at least see the doctors, and what we do now, we have the criteria that we need to investigate, like x-ray and MRI, to exclude the serious problem that like a pain generator to make pain again and again. It can be serious. If not, we refer to Dr. Suti to treat like either myofascial or office syndrome.
But for me, don't wait until 3 months until it change to chronic pain, because if pain become chronic pain, it's very difficult to correct.
It's harder to treat. Right?
Yeah.
Oh.
So just maybe a week, 2 weeks, if you don't feel better, come here.
Yeah, so the key is not to let it continue and persist, because there's going to be more injury and damage. Another question, is acupuncture helpful to cure the pain?
Yeah. You have to differentiate two things. Acupuncture, we usually mean Chinese acupuncture. They will use a little needle put on the specific point in your body. And that will affect to the other organ, affect to the energy line. This is the Chinese acupuncture. In Chinese medicine principle, they claim that the Chinese acupuncture can relieve pain and also improve the energy, so it can correct the office syndrome. But for me, the other kind of needle puncture we call dry needling. Dry needling is similar to Chinese acupuncture, but different in the method and principle. We will put the needle directly to the trigger point that we mentioned, and then use the needle tip to stimulate the muscle directly to make it relax. This used for treatment of myofascial pain syndrome.
I have been doing that once with Dr. Suti, and it's very effective indeed. Help to really, because sometimes the muscle just keep tightening, but it won't let go.
Right.
The trigger point is gone after releasing it. One person comment, very informative, thank you doctors. May you share your thoughts about the potential link between office syndrome and TMD and headache.
Sometimes office syndrome, especially the myofascial pain syndrome in the part of your shoulder and neck, it can produce the pain to your head and produce headache. This depends on where is the trigger point in your body. And the other kind of headache we call tension headache. This is different. This is the muscles around your head is very tense. Mostly is related to the stress. So we have to differentiate this thing. But it's very, very cross, and sometimes it happens together.
This is why it's very important to come see our specialists, so they could locate exactly where the origin of the pain is
yes.
and how it's related. The next one. Our office time, 8 hours, sometimes 3 to 4 continuous work. And then sometimes we have a back pain instead. Can you explain how that's related?
When we sit, we always use the back muscles. The back muscle is not the legs. Even you sit very long, it means the back muscle will work or contract very long. So it will be fatigue or increase the stress, strain inside the muscle fiber and can produce the permanent pain. And then if you always do like this, even you have pain, sometimes the pressure that take action along the spine, take action to the intervertebral, this will make the structural change permanently, and that will be the disease.
So this is a structural change, not just in the neck, but anywhere along the spine.
Yeah. Yes. So what you can do to prevent that from happening is if you have good chair, but if you don't lean on it, okay, if you have good chair, but you lean forward and work like this, so that chair is useless. Okay, so if you have good chair, lean on it with the lumbar support and then pull your chair close to the monitor. This is one thing. Another thing is you focus on your belly button and try to pull it to the spine from time to time. You cannot do it all the time.
Yeah.
Okay, but when you feel some tension or tight at your low back, you can do some stretching like the Suti toe, and after that you can straight up and swing yourself up like something is pulling the swing from your head, and then you pull your belly button to the spine. That helps to generate more strength from the front rather than put the load to the back muscle only.
Very important muscle group to prevent back pain we call core muscles. Core muscle is muscle around your body. Core muscle can increase the pressure inside your body, and this pressure can help to support the spine or absorb the force that come to the spine. So if you usually strengthen your core muscles, this will be very good to prevent back pain.
This is what you meant by the exercise.
Yes.
So does yoga help the spine alignment?
Yoga principle mostly is the stretching and flexibility. So I think the one that better than yoga is Pilates. Pilates, you take action to the small muscles, especially inside your body and core muscle. This will help you a lot for back pain.
And you have the stretching as well for the Pilates.
Okay. Yes. Will we ever be rid of the syndrome? Can we ever be rid of, rid of it completely?
Good question, but difficult. If you still work with the computer, with mobile phone, with tablet, or stay still in one place to work, you will face to office syndrome.
Yeah, if you are you do sport for a living, like a professional sport, you face this other problem as well.
Yeah.
So I think in conclusion, you need good posture. You have to remind yourself that you need good posture, either stand or sit. You need good muscle strength and endurance and flexibility. That means you exercise your core, every muscle, and stretching. So it's like you have to eat every day, so you need to exercise your muscles every day and keep the good posture. Most of the bad posture can be corrected by yourself. Okay, even for we have seen many old people come for consultation, like with some abnormal curve. Some doctor they suggest the long fusion, put the rod to correct the curve. Normally we ask the patient, can you remind yourself to stay longer? Maybe you need some stick in the front rather than big aggressive surgery to correct just the curve. Yeah, so most of that problem can be corrected by the patient himself.
Yeah, Yes, I think this is important, that as long as we have to work, we can still do things to take care or prevent.
Right.
And also, if you cannot really know how you look, like what posture you're in, we can always ask others to help us or come in for an evaluation, and our doctors, our physical therapists can also help see if your posture is correct. And even to advise on the working equipment, environment, and things like that too, right?
Correct.
How do we know if back pain is muscle or disc? I think they want some understanding.
Normally the first thing is, if it's the muscle, it can be severe pain as well, if muscle or disc. But if you have the pain from the muscle, it responds better with the medication and physiotherapy. But if it's a ruptured disc,
yes,
it doesn't respond that well or that quick. So we have patients coming to see us every day, acute back pain, severe. So we treat as a muscle, and this is very common question from the patient. Do I have to prep this? Do I have to do the MRI? I always tell, for now, we don't know. But if we do MRI today and we see prolapse disc, the initial treatment will be the same. Okay, most of the disc herniation, you don't need surgery, only 10-15%. Okay, so the initial treatment, rest, bed rest. Physical therapy, pain medication, anti-inflammatory. So I always instruct the patient, if this pain doesn't recover within 2 weeks, you come back. Or if the pain starts to radiate down to the leg, that's not the muscle, that's a nerve pain. We need MRI in that case. Okay, so we treat as a muscle. So if it recovers within 1 to 2 weeks, we blame the muscles. But if it keeps coming back, so that fall into the category that you might have the prolapse disc, we do MRI.
Actually, this can be very common to have pain together. Even you have a prolapse disc and produce one kind of pain, normal mechanism in human body, you make the muscle spasm to spring. That organ make it stay still, and this will make muscle produce the pain. And initially, the people will come and show the characteristic of their like a muscle. When we treat the muscle, make it relax, then you will see the other source inside.
Wow, yeah. It's so interrelated.
Yeah, but the key is you don't treat. Give the same treatment again and again without a closed end.
Yes.
Okay, at a certain point we need to investigate. You cannot blame muscle all the time. That's why we have to work together closely.
Mm-hmm. I can see now how the partnership between you as a neurosurgeon team and the physical medicine and rehabilitation team is so closely needed, so that it's not just one direction where one specialist refers to another.
Yes.
You both refer bidirectionally,
right,
and maybe multiple times in the process in order to create that holistic approach of treatment for our patients. Wow, this is very good. What about migraines? Because it's so similar to tension headache. Do you have any suggestions to prevent?
You have to differentiate.
Uh-huh.
Normally, the headache, migraine or non-migraine headache, such as tension headache, this is very difficult to differentiate.
Mm-hmm.
Mostly patients will go to see the neurologist for headache. They will have some criteria to differentiate. So, but most common of the headache should be from the muscle, not the migraine. So we can treat as a tension headache first. If it not improve, then you have to see the neurologist.
So very closely related. It can be from work, but our center will look at the muscles and the spine in relation,
right,
to each other. I think it's our last question now. I have tension pain very often. I usually have headache around the back of my head. Every morning even though I think I have enough sleep. Is this office syndrome?
Maybe yes or maybe no.
Yes.
This case should be related to the sleep abnormality or psychological stress. So you should find out in these two reasons and correct it first. The characteristic of headache from office syndrome usually happen in the afternoon after you work for a while, not start to have pain or headache when you wake up in the morning. This is the key.
So normally morning pain is not red flag, but we don't like morning pain.
Yeah.
It needs to be investigated.
Yeah, because we should feel rested and good at best at our morning. And this is my question. Do you employ stress reduction as part of your treatment for people with office syndrome? Does it help at all?
We should have, but practically very difficult because psychological stress is a lot of aspect to approach. It depends on personality of the patient, depend on how they work, depend on what is their family situation, their daily living. So it's a long story and need specialists or some people who have very good skill to find out and correct it.
Thank you. Okay, so I think that's all from the questions. Do you have any last words for us that you'd like to share with the audience before we finish our show today?
Prevention is better than treatment.
I'm going to say the same.
So then let it be. Just prevent it.
And for me, it's if prevention fails and you have problem, don't leave it too long.
Mm-hmm.
It will be more difficult to treat.
Yes.
Okay, that's it.
Okay, well, I really want to thank you, Adansity Adaniram-Han, today for coming in and giving us such a comprehensive understanding about office syndrome and how it could really be dangerous if we don't really take care of it. So again, thank you for both of you, Akunmanka, and thank you for all of you for attending our Facebook Live today, and we hope you enjoy our session today. If you have any more questions or comments, please feel free to comment in the Facebook Live, and we will be sure to get back to you. Thank you.